stream. Say hello. Super Bandit. Musical accompaniment by the Savage Times. Mr. Savage Times himself, Stripper Bandit. Remember that last game? We played with, I played with you and John. Club. Which one? The YMCA? Oh, okay. Yeah. That was cool. Showcase. Yeah, you were just chilling back there, but I get it. Yeah, There's a 30th. No! So yeah, how long have you been playing these games? Oh no. How long have you been playing this? Nice. Wait, are you watching the stream? How's the quality of it? Nice. What the fuck was that? Oh, a dazzling potato mine. That guy is pimped out for a cactus. Down in the library, defending books. No, I watch the movies. Yeah. Oh. What, the movies? They were good. I wasn't sure about the last one, because I guess they had to end it, but I don't know, I just had mixed feelings. Which one was your favorite? No. Oh yeah, doggy. Thank you. powerful. I hated Dobby.
Yeah, everyone loved him, but I hated him.
Just saying that. Just putting that out there. No, I get it. Did you see that? Okay. What'd he do? Uh-huh. Oh no. No, I get it though. I get it. Well, that's, you're one to do that. You put the savage in the savage times. Yeah. Yeah. Goblet of Fire, or I can't remember the order, because there's so many. It's like, what, 7 or 8? Crazy. But were you Team Hufflepuff like everybody else, the cool kids? No. Okay. Props to that. Everyone's either, oh, I'm Gryffindor, or, oh, I'm Slytherin. Yeah. No, don't be so hard on yourself. You're a complete nerd. That's all I see in you. That's all you are. You know what book I like that I read that they made a movie out of? So, Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. Like, the first one was good, but then, what's his name? Tim Burton got his hands on it and made that that fucking, that acid trip of a remake. No. What was there to like? I mean, I guess if you're into, like, it wasn't disturbing, but it didn't really capture the original one. I mean, it was Tim Burton doing what he does with whatever he puts his hands on. Have you seen the Batman? Like, the Batman ones with, fuck, who was Batman in those? I can't remember. I think it was George Clooney? Yeah, the Penguin and Catwoman. Yeah. Damn, there's no one in this game. Hold on. Return to the backyard. But yeah, so I like watching the first one for nostalgia's sake. So I like this game. I like that it has, you know, class balance. I've noticed that not a lot of people play. I mean, I guess it could also depend on the time you play, but not a whole bunch of people play. Oh, yeah, like right away. Yeah, it's weird. Let's see, last time I did, what was it, turf takeover? Let's do a mix. No, I don't blame, like, it's just one of those things where you just don't think about it, because it was captured, like, really well, and, yeah, no, I actually saw the movie before I read the book, like, fully. Don't judge me. Like how people who read books that got turned into movie adaptations do.
Why are you
gonna like B.
Shut up.
She's like, no, it's not supposed to be that way. They weren't like that.
Seriously.
The movie got it all wrong. The book was better. Whatever, man. Talking to yourself. Oh, okay.
Harry Potter books, I went to school with him. Not Potter.
Yeah?
Oh, boy. So I went there, and I spent a lot of my time reading like that. So I read the Harry Potter books, and I took the other books. I was just like,
The Hobbit? Yeah, but I quit school and started on the library, so...
So basically, after sixth grade, I didn't go to school with the library.
Yeah, it does.
Change the subject, change the subject.
It's pretty brief.
It looks like some kind of post-apocalyptic. Oh, whatever.
Whatever, it happened.
Sometimes. But, you read comics, right?
Yeah.
What's the any of the groups of comics? Or, actually, just in general, favorite comics?
Well, in general, like, Spider-Man, always been a fan of Spider-Man. I used to have a big collection. Just the whole Spider-Man, like, the villains and everything, just, I love them. Like, Venom is probably my favorite, right behind Carnage. Like, I love Symbiote from it, they're the best, like, they're just awesome. All the Spider-Man. DC is best ones are like Batman and Superman. The rest of the villains like suck.
Yeah. I agree.
You know those TV shows about the DC heroes, like the Flash and Green Arrow. Do you like those at all?
Yeah, I like them.
Which one do you like?
I liked Green Arrow.
Oh yeah.
But the new one came out on Netflix. So I watched that and I didn't hate it, but I was pretty close to hating it.
Pretty close. Yeah. Oh, run!
But, the Flash, I like the Flash.
Yeah, I watched it too, up until the point where, who's his name? The Timekeeper or whatever? Clockmaster? Fuck, I don't know. His special power is that he never loses track of time or some shit.
Okay, yeah.
He's like holding up a bank and like he's like talking to the cops on the phone. And he's like he's like, time is always on my side. Like, and his big thing is like his dramatic point was he held a woman at gunpoint and he checked his watch to make like a dramatic monologue about like time and stuff. It's like a year has 1,4500 seconds and 13. Like, bro, shut the fuck up. You're so weak. And in the end, the Flash just like takes away his gun and he's powerless because he's just some weirdo with goggles and a watch. Oh, hey, nice. So after that, I was kind of taken out of the the Flash. I was unimmersed in the Flash TV universe. But I did.
Yeah, I have definitely cringing moments sometimes.
Yeah.
Oh, but you were saying you did what?
I did like it up to a certain point, though. Like, you can tell they're like low budget, but they capture a good amount of heart that each of the comics go for, and I like that, and I appreciate it.
Yeah, that sounds like season one.
Yeah.
Season 2 after that was cool. This last season, season 3, I thought that was the best of all of them.
Did he ever face the old Flash? Like, did they ever get to that?
The old Flash.
the first Flash, I guess.
That was the first Flash?
Yeah.
No. No, but I was confused because it just confused me. I don't want to ruin anything.
Oh, right. In case one of our two viewers hasn't seen it yet.
Well, this is for you, just in case like you want to go watch.
Oh no, I ain't gonna watch it.
Oh, run,
please.
Do you have Netflix?
What? Do I live in a fucking cave? Yeah. Why would you ask that? How dare you? Oh, what? Luna Freak 2169. He says, Ma5.
Ma5?
I don't know.
Oh, yeah, high five.
Cool.
Oh, but, this, like, they're all on Netflix. Like, it's all caught up on Netflix. I would recommend Flash for season 3. Like, if you could watch whole thing, and it'd be worth me for season 3.
Alright, so, you heard it here first. Watch the Flash. Oh!
Watch the Flash.
Yeah. The Savage Times is now an official sponsor. No, we should get sponsored now by The Flash.
Yeah, we should get paid for that.
Yeah. Somebody contact, who is it, Warner Brothers? I don't know.
I think Warner Brothers.
Yeah. Get them on the horn. Tell them I'd like some money, please.
On the horn,
on the horn, buddy.
What is this, like the 50s?
You know it.
Hit him.
Oh no.
Oh, he jumped over.
Help me. Get him. Nice.
Just there, dude. Just there.
Nah, yeah, some
keep,
other.
Keep my cool.
Yeah, keep it together. You're the glue that holds the team together.
What the?
This guy's alone.
Got him.
Thank you.
Oh,
what is this guy? Nice.
He scared me in the waistband. I'm so on it. Oh, do you watch the Marvel shows?
Yeah, I've seen some of Jessica Jones.
Isn't that great?
It's pretty good so far. I just started it, so no spoilers.
Oh, so you haven't gotten to look at the script?
Oh no! Don't you dare! Don't you? That ain't cool. So to our two viewers, no spoilers. Don't type anything from The Flash. Don't type anything from Jessica Jones. Yeah.
Did you watch Daredevil?
Did watch what?
Daredevil?
Daredevil, no. I don't like blind people, so. Why did you laugh? You're a horrible person. But I never got into the Daredevil. I never liked him really as like as a superhero, just because.
You think the idea is stupid?
That and I don't get like he's blind, but he's like what a better type of blind guy because he has like supersonic hearing and positioning, so he can fight crime.
You better believe it.
Believe it! Okay, I believe it. So, fine. I still don't like him, though.
Yeah, I mean, whatever.
I can see how he, you know, he helped his... Oh, my...
Are you okay?
No, I got trapped. There was a 5v1. But, yeah. Oh, cool. We got another person in the chat. We got 3 people. Yes. It's a fucking record. Beautiful. How do you like being in the stream? Is it weird?
In me?
Yeah, you.
No.
Oh, I forgot. You're a professional. You used to get paid, right?
Yes. I get paid a million.
Yes. What was your old handle? Your old YouTube handle?
It cut off pretty quick.
You caught on quick? Oh, wow. Or were you up to like 100,000 viewers, right?
100 billion.
100 billion subscribers. Yeah, you were.
Yeah, I mean, they say there's only like 70 people in the world, but.
But, dude, they just came out as a woodwork for you.
Yeah,
on YouTube.
Sick.
Yeah, dude. You were up against PewDiePie and all the greats.
Who's that?
I know. I only just heard about that guy. Like, I was watching nobody but, like, you for a while.
Well, yeah. I like that.
I know. Someone mentioned PewDiePie the other day, and I was like, who the fuck? And they showed me a video. I'm like, okay, that's kind of funny. So.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can tell.
Oh my god!
Stupid goat. I love turning people into goats.
Oh, but back to the Netflix. Did you see Iron Fist?
No. He is one of the, like, lesser known, Marvel superheroes that I actually am really interested in. I can't bring myself, though, to watch it, because... I don't know, I don't want him to ruin it. Is it good?
It's okay.
Oh no.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah. It was okay. But you know, it's Marvel, and things can't just be okay.
I know, that's what I'm saying. Marvel is, I don't get it. They're great in the box office. They have funny, witty, relatable, you know, dialogue for their characters, and then you get to the Netflix series and it's just boom, where does all that quippy writing go to?
Whoa, I wanna say all of
heresy.
Them.
Heresy, I say.
Cause Daredevil, I highly recommend it. Jessica Jones, I highly recommend it. Luke Cage, I highly recommend it.
Wow.
Iron Fist, I recommend, only because it goes with the Defenders, which just came out. Did you hear about that?
I saw that it got released, yeah. It has Iron Fist and like you said, Jessica Jones, Luke Cage, who else?
Yeah. Daredevil?
Oh, yeah, and Daredevil. It has the Punisher too, right?
I'm not sure. I'm 6 episodes in.
Oh, okay. And what was that other one that came too? Humans, or... Not humans,
Inhumans?
Inhumans, yes.
Yeah, I don't know about that. I mean, I'm gonna go check it out. But... Did you ever see that, this is going to lead to the Marvel thing. Did you ever see, that show, Dexter?
Dexter?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Loved it for a while. Like, we watched, like, 5 seasons of it.
Yeah, me too.
yeah, but we stopped after that. Like, no, didn't see the end because we kind of got turned off with the fact that run, run. Oh, I got blown the fuck up. No, it's just like every season, like he almost gets caught, but then he never gets caught, so it's like. There's like a little tension at the end of it, you know?
Yeah.
Like, you know what's gonna happen.
You don't need to see the end. You really don't.
No. Help me. Yeah, then what is the end? Like, you can. I'm gonna say it right now. Whoever's watching. If you haven't seen the ending of Dexter, you're gonna get it ruined right now. So press mute or something. Dylan from the Savage Times is gonna tell us what happened at the end of the series Dexter. So go ahead.
Yes. So at the end, his sister dies and he takes her body and puts her in the ocean.
Really?
And he goes to like live in like I don't know, Washington, somewhere in the city. Like a lumberjack.
Wow, a lumberjack, huh?
Anyways, I guess the guy who wrote a lot of stuff, well, some of that stuff in some episodes I really didn't like, was the showrunner for Iron Fist.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's weird.
So,
oh, that ain't
but
cool.
Further on that, the showrunner who did all that and was the showrunner for Iron Fist is not even the showrunner anymore. And he got me to,
Yeah, actually.
Oh, yeah. I think from that point. Like, now he will ruin it anymore if it was him. But, in the end, maybe it can be. Okay.
I just gotta comment on this game. They're doing really well with those stupid fucking chompers, man. I got like devoured like twice in a row.
Yeah. It's not easy to pull that off.
No.
The pea shooters are kind of playing safe. Chompers are, you know.
Yeah, just got chomped on.
Oh, man.
Oh, no. Oh, nice. confused at the last second. No. Comic books are just, it's one of those mediums where, like, I kind of always like and appreciate what the artist does, unless...
Okay, yeah.
Unless it's, what, like, a movie adaptation of a comic book to where it's like, you know, like, why would you do that? The movie already kind of happened. But, yeah, what was it? Getting back into, like, the Venom franchise. And, we went out and got, like, some Guardian of the Galaxy comic books just to check those out.
Gotta say,
liked them all.
That's cool.
What was it? But you frequent...
No, too.
Yeah, you frequent the comic book store a lot.
I do.
What was the, what's the last series you read?
Excuse me.
Black Bolt. Black Bolt, huh?
Yeah, I highly recommend them.
Yeah, Black Bolt is, Marvel?
Yeah, Inhumans. He's a part of Inhumans. He's like the king.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, what is it? Number four just came out. This month? So yeah, I'd recommend those. No. Job on the show, compared to the show, compared to the new show.
The new show. Oh, you're not a fan. Simpsons.
I never thought of it that way.
She's she. You gotta admit, in later episodes, she's kind of starred. And I say starred as in, you know, spearheading most of the episodes. Yeah, in like the later seasons.
Yeah.
It's not
oh,
bad.
That guy killed himself.
He tripped. It's funny. Oh no.
I give them sometimes. I watch the newer ones.
Yeah.
Laugh a little bit. But I don't know, the writing's just not there for me.
Yeah. What, favorite season of The Simpsons? Right now, go.
I'd say number one, but number one didn't have a Treehouse of Horror.
Wow.
I love the Treehouse. Like, I'll still watch those. But, maybe two or three.
Damn, really? That early?
Yeah. Yeah, that's pretty good.
But you're,
But, like, anything from the first, like, 1 to 9 or 10... is golden.
Yeah, I gotta say, like, 10 or, like, anything like before 10, I, like, just love. Like, I love how memorable they all are. At those times. Oh! We all just stood there.
Yeah. Well, one of my favorite episodes is, what is it? Behind the Ladder.
What season is that?
I think it was 9. Maybe even 11? I'm not too sure. That's one of my favorite episodes. You remember that one?
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
Yeah. That and Bart Sells His Soul?
Yeah.
Yeah, when he gets his bike gets ran over by the street sweeper and all that happens.
Yeah.
That's one of my favorite moments.
Did you happen to see the Pokemon one that came out a couple months ago? Pokemon Go. It was, I didn't see it all the way. I just saw like the musical segment they had with Well, have you seen the premise is like Lisa and Homer discover Pokemon Go, but they don't call it Pokemon Go because, you know, and what was it? Homer realizes that you can just buy like all you need with real money, but he does that, but Lisa's like the purist. She's like, yeah, you gotta walk around and get Pokemon Go. What would I do that? And you know, in the classic Homer voice.
Yeah.
It was interesting. I like their kind of doing more purple commentary, like South Park does. Except South Park does it funnier because they're a mature show and they can do that. They can make it raunchier what it needs to be.
South Park doing
sound good, I would imagine.
Their writing's not getting stale or anything like that?
No, they're, they're just so outrageous, they kind of stay ahead of themselves, like, each of the episodes will have their own thing, and, like, their own saying they just, like, call back to, like, it just doesn't get old, in my opinion. Huh? What the heck?
What happened?
Nothing. It's,
oh, shit.
This part of the stream is brought to you by Smucker's Uncrustables.
Oh, nice.
Smucker's Uncrustables. When you don't want to take the crust off your fucking PB&J.
Lazy.
It's the perfect product for lazy people like me. Shut up, we've all been there.
I haven't.
Okay.
Oh, but back to South Park. I heard that they did some kind of a, like, long-form story thing. Like, it all was, like, one big story? What season?
Really? That's crazy.
I mean, I know they kind of do that in general, but yeah, I heard it was like actual, I don't know the term, but it just, it completed itself.
So like every episode was a continuation.
Yeah.
Crazy. No, I didn't hear that. Yeah, because, okay, can we just talk about how stupid Family Guy is for a second? Can I put that out there?
Yes.
Just,
Amazing.
God, thank you. Just, low effort. Peeta, I can't believe you're doing this and this and this and this. Oh, time for a flashback. Remember when we did this? Oh, Peeta. that's what it boils down to. But I would put South Park in or Simpsons in better regard.
Yeah, I would too. I don't really care for the newer episodes.
Yes. Yes.
I think that people agree with me on Family Guy.
Well, I mean,
kind of a little emotional.
You did. You got too excited there. Oh.
Ready on your thing?
Parts were funny, though. Like, there's just some of those classic pop culture moments that Family Guy spawned, and you gotta appreciate that, too.
Like what?
Like what? Boy, you remember in school, and as soon as someone started going, ah, you were just like, you were just fucked out immediately because you knew. I knew that played out pretty quick.
No, but legitimately, I don't know that.
You don't?
I don't get that reference.
Wow. So in the first, first couple seasons, I think it's the first season. What was it? Oh, yeah, it was like a type of episode like Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, except it was a beer company that was in town, and they put golden tickets in the beer, and if you found one, you get to take the tour, the big tour. And he found one, like, you know how Charlie Bucket does. He, like, doesn't find one, but then he finds one at the very, he, like, finds the very last one. And then, oh, stripper bandit, I'll save you. Oh, no, I won't.
I saw that. No.
But yeah, so Peter finds the last golden ticket, and, you know, like in the movie, an old guy's like, run, Peter, run as fast as you can, and it plays the Charlie Bucket song, like, na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na.
Yeah.
And then as soon as he's, like, right in front of his house, Peter trips on a piece of the sidewalk, like a crack in the sidewalk, and then the music stops, and he just sits, and he holds his knee, and doubles over. He's like, and then he does that. It goes on for like 15 more seconds until it just like stops. And it was just a crazy annoying Family Guy thing. But then that's okay. their kind of brand of humor. Like later on, Stewie, he's trying to get Lois's attention. He's like, Ma. Ma, Ma, Mama, 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 Mom. Like, have you seen that?
I've seen that one.
Okay, yeah. So, you know how annoying they can be.
Yeah. The first little bit. I get that. That probably makes me laugh a little bit. The second one, that one,
not so, yeah.
I didn't get it. Yeah, man, kids do that, whatever. It didn't seem to be like the same thing.
I know, right? No.
You died.
Oh no.
No, but I don't like family.
Like, you hate it? I get it.
When I was younger, I was more critical of it. Now I've kind of toned down. I mean, I'm not gonna like, oh yeah, I'm gonna go buy the first season of Family Guy. The first 5 seasons of Family Guy or whatever. But I've calmed down on my criticizing.
Oh, okay. Let me ask you this, do you like Adam Sandler movies?
You see, I can't say that I don't because I'll watch them.
Okay.
Like those Netflix ones he's been doing. Oh, like, you know, I'm not doing anything. But it's okay at times.
Yeah, I mean, like, I'll always like his earlier movies, like like Billy Madison. Actually, Billy Madison is the one I always go to because the other characters and how they're written is just, I love it. Like, you've seen Billy Madison, right? Or no?
Yeah.
Okay, well, that one scene where, like, he's having, like, one of his final, like, celebrations, like, graduation celebrations, and, like, his friend Frank is just sitting there spraying a kid with like, a garden hose in the face, and the kid's like, stop it, mister. what are you doing? Who are you? Go away, mister. And the kid Frank, or the guy Frank's just sitting there like, like, and then Billy Madison's like, you okay? And he's like, yeah. And then they just end it right there. I just love the execution of that scene. Oh, let's see, in the chat, Iron Lotus 1045 put the Water Boy. Yeah, I do like the Water Boy as well. A lot of good classic scenes from, you know, they contributed to pop culture.
It was okay.
Yeah, I think overall... I know. I'm a little critical of that one, too, because... I don't know. Just... That was at the point where Adam Sandler started to more rely on, like... Well, how we see Adam Sandler now. Like Jack and Jill? Bro, don't even say that. Jack and Jill. Just ridiculous.
Did you see that? Did you see it?
No, I refuse to. Like, I do know what happens in it, though. Like, bro, do you realize, like, that one part where they're just on the cruise for, what was it? I don't know. I just know they go on a cruise, and it's basically an entire commercial for, like, Western Caribbean Cruise Lines. They're like, welcome to Western Caribbean Cruise Lines, and it shows, like, everything you do, and it's just a fucking commercial. They put in the... There's no point to it all. There's, like, you know, there's a little Adam Sandler humor here and there. Like, oh, this guy farted. Oh, Jill fell down. You know, classic, you know, well, current Adam Sandler stuff right now. But,
You make it sound hilarious.
If he delivered it would have been way funnier.
Yeah.
But, no, I'm saying he should hire me, and I'll just do most of his movies for him. That's all I'm saying.
I'd pay for that.
But, yeah, and then just, oh yes, revive me.
Don't worry.
Oh, this guy got me. Oh, run, Colonel Tom. Bandits 187 in the chat.
That's me. Just replying to Iron Lotus.
Oh, okay. Oh my god. But yeah.
Yeah.
Adam Sandler right now is just... You can tell.
Why do you think, why is it like that? Like, why isn't it gold?
Okay, here's the thing. Adam Sandler, he had a lot of promise, but he stated early on that if he could just do it all for money, he would. And that's, like, he was a stand-up before he went on SNL. He said that a few times, like, oh, I want to make a lot of money and just do that. And that's basically where he went to. He followed the money, he got lazy with it, and... And he's just, it's a cash grab. Like, you notice, like, you see a lot of his old SNL friends in everything now. Like, David Spade, what was that other guy? James, what's his name? Paul Blart? Kevin James, there we go.
Was he on that stuff?
No, he's a stand-up, though, that...
Oh, okay.
That he's, like, in Adam Sandler's, like, friend circle. You know, okay, I will say this. Whenever people bring up Rob Schneider, like, oh, you know, he's a comedian, he's on SNL. When people say he's a comedian, I'm like, no, he's not a comedian. Rob Schneider is Adam Sandler's friend, and that's how he's successful. That's it. just, I agree. Have you seen his stand-up? Bro, it's not funny. His show, they have Netflix, not funny. He thinks he's funny, and that's the funny part. That's the only thing. Like, he'll act like a comedian.
Oh, terrible.
But I'll laugh at him, like, bro, you're not a comedian. Get off the stage. Who let you do this?
Yeah.
But anyway, welcome to the Savage Times. this is the Savage Times. Brought to you.
But okay, so it's just, it's easy money, really.
Yeah, it's just easy money. Like, he made a couple movies, like, in the beginning, like Billy Madison and, you know, Waterboy and some other things earlier in his career. Amassed a lot of fans. And he started getting a reputation for doing this type of humor, and that was it. Like, he just had his fan base, and he made movies. They all watched it. It was just easy money for him. And it's a real shame, because, you know, he can be funny. Oh! No, I'm dancing. Okay. No. Oh, I completely messed that up.
He keeps his ass up. He's a cute. He knows. But he's just, I'm making money, whatever.
No, bro. I'm sure he knows. Like, have you seen Adam Sandler lately? He looks so miserable, dude. Like, he just looks tired and miserable. Like, whenever he has to do, like, promo spots on, like, talk shows, he's just like, you can tell he just put on jeans and a t-shirt and he's like, oh, okay, I'm here. What do you want to say? Yeah, go see the movie. Yeah, it's disappointing, because, it's, yeah. I mean, he did what any of us would do, for the most part. Just, you know, follow the money. Get some money for you and your friends, there you go.
Action on the Savage Times.
Savage Times, 24/7. Brought to you by Flash.
Yes. WD. Or CW, that's what it is.
Oh, CW, I'm sorry.
Which, I don't know, what is that? Is that WB?
Yeah, I think it, I think they just changed their name to the CW. It's still Warner Brothers in part, I think. Yes, Savage Times 24/7 brought to you by Jessica Jones from Marvel.
Jessica Jones, Daredevil. Oh, he put in too.
Daredevil, yeah, he put in, getting some money too. So, oh, I'm sorry, I gotta read this script that Daredevil bought me, or he sent me. Daredevil's a good show. You should watch it. Okay, cool. That's all. That's all $20. All the $20 that you buy here on the Savage Times.
Do you think that's how much it is? Like, I'd do that for $20. That's easy.
Oh, yeah. I'm sure, like, it depends on who you ask. Like, Conan. Oh. If you get Conan to, like, try to endorse you, it's going to cost, like, well, it's going to be more than $20.
Yeah.
He's not just going to be like, oh, yeah, just spot me a 20, bro. Like.
Yeah. Maybe. Seems like a nice guy.
Yeah.
No. That's cool. When you're talking.
You gotta wonder that, like, Conan O'Brien seems like a cool dude, but I always think, like, what if you meet him and they're just, like, assholes? But you know they won't be. Conan, he's just seasoned with guys, so. He's just good. Good-hearted guy.
He seems like he's down. Yeah, he seems like he's down for the cause.
Yeah, he's down to earth, you know. Loves his fans.
I really appreciate that. Thank you, Conan.
Conan O'Brien, if you're watching this, thank you.
I'm still stuck on the Adam Sandler thing, but I mean... That just happens, doesn't it? It just... Well, people get comfortable. That's... Well, yeah.
Yeah, man, Adam Sandler is just one of the glaring examples, I would say.
What was somebody who doesn't do that?
What, someone who doesn't shell out for money and just tries to make quality product all the time?
Yeah, who's making the quality right now?
The quality, in their respective genres, it varies. Like, we can start with comedy right now. If you're looking for like a big comedy star who only, you know, does quality things all the time, who pops to mind? Something funny all the time, every time. It's tough. Like, you'll think of them like what money or what movie could you just always watch every time, and it's always funny. I guess, Simon Pegg and, you know, the guys who made, Hot Fuzz. I could watch Simon Pegg movies for, like, days. There's layers upon layers of good writing, good comedy, good interaction with his characters. They're always relatable, but most importantly, they're always funny, and they always take the movies seriously. They never dumb it down for their audiences. They're just... another example you could see, you know, we all know Kevin Hart. We all know Kevin Hart. We love him. He's an American sweetheart, but... But he's doing the same thing.
Oh, I'm hit by the train.
You're a pancake. But, yeah, Kevin Hart, too. He's going for the money, man. That's why all of his latest movies, like...
Yeah.
Even though he doesn't... Everyone can act in their own right. I'm just saying, he doesn't... He can't act. He can only do one thing, is what I'm trying to say. He's one type of character, which is, like... He'll play normal, and then he'll play the bitch a little bit because he's small, and he'll be funny with all his lines later on.
Yeah, that's... I agree with that.
He's funny, though, like, in a lot of cases. But, yeah, another... It's just tough, like, get good, they just throw money at you and you just get lazier and lazier. Like, what are the genres you into? You like the sci-fi movies? Like,
yeah.
Oh, okay.
Pretty much anything.
Right on.
Who's killing it right now? You know, who's just making greats?
Just making greats all around.
Greatest hits. Well, I gotta say Marvel's been a cool guy.
Oh yeah, Marvel. They can do no wrong at the moment. Well, I gotta admit, they just have it down. And I'm hoping for them not to get lazy with it.
I know, I keep thinking they're gonna peak and then it's gonna suck. But they just keep on going.
Yep. Yeah, DC, they need to step it up. No. No. It's not fair. Okay, because really, they should have left Batman with Christian Bale, in my opinion. Because he did okay with it. I love, like, my favorite was, well, I don't know, I just really liked Heath Ledger's The Joker in it, and it was great. Him and Christian Bale, like, they actually worked out their relationship, how it was going to be with the director, Christopher Nolan, like, he was really into it. You could tell, he actually really wanted to make those movies. And,
he did not die.
Oh, Heath Ledger died, yes, but not Christopher Nolan. Yeah. What was I at? So yeah. It was just a really written. Now Ben Affleck playing Batman, like, why? There was no need for that. And yeah. Man of Steel just put me to sleep. Like, I could not watch that movie. Yeah.
I actually kind of like that one, but I a lot of people say that.
Yeah, no, it was,
Yeah, I love it.
Yeah, I couldn't get into it for the most part. I love, but one thing I do love, though, was, like, he's like, I gotta protect Smallville, I gotta protect Smallville, and then in the last scene, they're just fucking up Smallville, like, he's fucking up Main Street, he's fucking up all the buildings in that final fight. I love it. It was like ironic justice. Oh, look, there you are.
Alright.
Yeah. And then, yeah, DC's Wonder Woman was supposedly really good, and, you know, good for them. It only took them, what, 4 tries to actually make a good one?
It was okay.
Yeah. Like, what?
I think people were only saying that because of the whole female superhero thing.
Yeah. Which I really don't get. Like, all the titles, like, in BuzzFeed and everything, like, finally, women and young girls have a female to look up to on the screen, like, in, like, the comic book world or sci-fi. Like, I don't...
Yeah, it's...
Yeah, she empowered all women.
It's just too bad that movie did that, is what I think.
Yeah, they had to pull the political card, and then... No, but, yeah, it's just sad. They couldn't just make a good movie on their own merit. Like, what's wrong? Who are they... Who's directing all this trash that they're making? Who's doing it?
Zack Snyder, I'll say Zack Snyder.
Oh, it's Zack... Oh, fuck. Fuck, why'd you have to say it? Now he's gonna send lawyers to come get us.
Yeah, there goes the stream.
Fuck, alright. This was the first and last episode of The Savage Time.
I'm coming to save you.
I got wrecked. They came out of nowhere.
That's nice.
Woo! I'm gonna take the boy. I'm the little guy.
Yeah, I thought Man of Steel was okay for a start. Then they went straight into that Batman vs. Superman scene. Oh, I was so upset.
Yeah, dude, they could not wait to start Batman vs. Superman, which is... It's like, dude, we were so desperate. Like, it started off so quick. Like, Marvel did it perfect. They made all the movies first, and then they made a group movie, like The Avengers or what have you.
Yeah.
This one, they did the exact opposite. Like, they made trash, like, single movies for the most part, and then they tried to do a group, which was, like, why? Why? Why would you do that?
Yeah, it was disappointing. I was like, I'm not gonna pay for that. I'm not gonna buy a ticket. Even if someone asks me, I just won't go. I'm not gonna buy it.
Yeah.
When it comes out.
Just out of principle. Like, just.
Yeah.
Not.
So I saw it on TV.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
Oh, another Zack Snyder production. No, I did not.
Don't.
That's fair enough. I won't. What's the next one they're coming out with? They're coming out with, Justice League. They're bringing in Cyborg from the Teen Titans, which, okay, they're kind of bringing in that part of the universe. Cyborg was okay, not my favorite. If I had to pick one, I would go with Beast Boy or like Starfire, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But, and then they're bringing in America's favorite, Aquaman. Everyone loves Aquaman, right? Hey everybody, I can talk to fish. Don't you like me?
No.
Exactly. Yeah, Aquaman, why? Like, that's what. Okay, can we just shift gears for a second and talk about, what was that? That Abomination Suicide Squad?
I shuddered.
I heard that. I think when that movie came out, half of the country shuddered as well. Like,
thank God they did.
Why would they do that?
That movie was terrible.
Just. What was it? Okay, I gotta say, I'm pretty pissed off that they were like, they had a showcase to, you know, they tried to make the whole cast diverse, you know. I actually was kind of, like, wondering, like, why they brought in, like, what was it, like a Native American superhero like we did with Slipknot. And it was just to kill him, like, right at the fucking beginning. Like, bro, you can't leave him in? You gotta fucking kill him right away? Like, what was the deal with that? Yeah. It sends a message to all, like, Native American Captain superheroes. Okay. Yeah, basically. Hey, now.
Yeah, that movie was just...
So yeah.
And the Joker,
Yeah, I know, man. It's just like, they saw an opportunity that the Joker was bringing in. Which is like, oh, everyone loves the Joker. Oh, everyone loves, Harvey Birdman. No, what's her name? Harley Quinn. Let's make it. I know. Let's make a movie showcasing them for the most part. Ha ha ha. Ha ha ha. We're gonna make money off this, guys. Let's do it. Oh my. There was like five of them right here. But Yeah, I don't get it. Like, I just don't get it. Why do you think... You know what I think every time they make a bad comic book movie? I always say to myself, in my nerdy little voice, I say in my head, I say, I could have done better. And I could have, if they would have given the rights to me, I would have. And I think, like, a lot of, like, nerdy comic book fans would think the same. Like, they could have done better, they could have actually captured the spirit of how the characters were. Because the source material speaks for itself. If it's good writing in the comic, you don't have to worry about your characters. You don't gotta make them, like, diverse.
Yeah, it's like something to build on. You got, like, a foundation.
Yeah, it's just a good foundation. The comic robot, you bastard.
Yeah,
they are. Sunflowers putting in work, man.
Yeah. It hurts. It don't hurt. But it's just so... Oh. To see people like... I can see it on Instagram
a lot.
People be like, these are my favorite movies of the year, or some people even go as far as saying it's like all time. And you have Batman vs. Superman and Suicide Squad on that list.
Oh, yeah, I know, it's really sad. You can tell, like, what is it?
Desperation.
Exactly, desperation. Either for followers or if they're big enough, I always think that, you know, DC, like, paid them to say that. Well, if you're just joining us here on Savage Times, talking about, you know, just discussing comic book movies that don't do the source material justice, i.e.
Suicide Squad. Batman vs. Superman?
Oh, and Batman vs. Superman. Just horrible reboots and remakes. Just, that's the subject we're on right now, and thank you for tuning in. So, Super Bandit, we've talked about bad ones. Now let's talk about the good ones. Let's refresh our palate. Talk about some good comic book movies. I don't know if you saw, actually I do know, that you saw the new Spider-Man, Homecoming.
I did.
And it was such a breath of fresh air, just especially compared to the latest Amazing Spider-Mans with Garfield, what's his name? Andrew Garfield, what's his name?
I did not see those actually.
Yeah, you didn't see him? Oh man, no. I'm jealous of you, to be honest. don't look them up, don't watch them. I got hit by the train, I was on top of the storage thing. Anyway, it was ridiculous, especially the last one with Jamie Foxx as Spider-Man's Electro. Just ridiculous premise. If you want to know the whole motivation between Spider-Man and Electro. It's that Electro is mad that Spider-Man doesn't remember his birthday. Yeah, that's the whole reason. Like, the guy who became Electro met Spider-Man in real life, and he's like, oh, I love you, Spider-Man, I love you. Don't you remember me? And Spider-Man's, like faking it. He's like, oh, yeah, haha. Okay, see you later, buddy. And the guy who becomes Electro is like, oh, I hate Spider-Man now. And then he becomes Electro, and that's the whole point. That's his whole motivation for hating Spider-Man. Yeah. Could you tell they were gonna get the Oscar or the Emmy or whatever comes first?
Maybe the Razzie?
The Razzie, yes. That would have been more fitting. But oh yeah, and then the first one, where Spider-Man, Andrew Garfield Spider-Man, has to fight the lizard. I don't know if you... Do you know the Spider-Man comics?
No.
Okay, well, in the comics, the lizard was actually a compatriot to Peter Parker's father. They did a lot of research together. You know, Harvey... Or not, Spider-Man went to the lizard. I can't remember his name. Professor something. Peter went to him with... science kit, like, they did research together, you know, they're good friends. But in The Amazing Spider-Man, the first one, the lizard just, he turned himself into a lizard accidentally because he wanted to regrow his arm, and then he wanted to turn the whole city into lizards. That was fucking it. That was fucking it. That was his whole motivation. Everyone needs to be lizards now. It was uncomfortable. And yes. So back to our point of good comic book movies. The Spider-Man Homecoming really hit it on the nose, from how Peter Parker's character is to his struggle with being a superhero and being a teenager. It got high marks for me, I was gonna say.
Yeah.
The whole movie without saying the Vulture name, which I gotta give him credit for, because, you know, it's not, there was fan service in there, don't get me wrong, but it wasn't so much fan service to where they had to say the Vulture's name over and over and over to get everyone a nerd bone. Like, he knew who he was, he played to his story well, and it was a convincing enough story. You got attached to him, and you thought, yeah, he's kind of doing it for a good cause in the beginning. And then I liked it. I really, really liked it.
I really did too. I didn't see it coming.
Yeah. I was really hopeful, and they really delivered, and that kind of restored my faith in Hollywood just a little bit more. Yes, I do love the what's his name? The actor that plays him now? I can't remember. Oh, Stripper Bandit. I will not fail you. Yes, I didn't fail you. I didn't die this time. I just got it. Thank you.
What did you think about Logan?
I saw Logan, or we just saw Logan recently, and it was really good. Like, obviously, the way that the trailer was displayed, it, you know, it's not the classic X-Men Marvel experience, you know, but I didn't realize how bittersweet it was going to be, man. It caught me off guard, and I can't lie, I did like it. They liked how it turned out.
Yeah. loved it.
Yes, I did too. Yes. Especially the end with like, okay, should we, not to get into too much spoilers here for anybody. I don't know if anyone's not seen Logan, so I won't spoil it. But I'll just say those, I don't know, the end, I really like the end. Without giving too much away, that ending scene, I really like it.
Yeah, it was very pretty. It's not every day you get to see a hero end up like that.
Go that way. Yes, I get what you're saying. Nice. Sticking to the no spoilers. Oh, did we do it?
We did it.
Yes. Thumbs up. Thumbs up.
Let's see. What about Guardians of the Galaxy? What did you think
of? Oh, man. Loved both of the Guardians of the Galaxy. Just, just great theater movie. I mean, if people didn't get a chance to watch it in theaters, it's a damn shame.
Yeah.
Oh, stripper bandit.
I did that.
But, yeah, the first one, just fun experience. Second one, they just kept the spirit of it alive and added what they needed to this. They didn't tweak it so much to where it broke it or made things unlikable. It was just a good balance overall.
Mm-hmm.
And I appreciated that. That's that's like three series that are really successful right now. Let's switch gears again and go back to some failed reboots. Let's go way back. Let's go to the before the 2000s. Like, so do any superhero movies stand out in your memory that have failed?
Like way back?
Not too way back, but like around 2000s or like in the 90s, like man.
Okay, so kind of early 2000s, the Superman Returns.
Which one?
I saw that. Superman Returns.
Superman Returns. Oh, okay.
I saw that, you know, as a kid, and I liked it. I maybe a year ago, saw it again.
Oh, yeah?
I get why everybody didn't like it. Definitely.
Yeah. Oh, damn, they're just playing all chompers, huh? Okay. Yeah, they're playing all chompers. Yeah, I actually didn't watch that. That one. Yeah, no, I didn't.
You didn't miss much.
Okay, that's good to know.
I wouldn't be like, all you need is watches. You just need to see it.
Yeah, being a fanboy. Oh no. Have you seen Spawn?
One?
Did they make a second one?
No. What? They are making a new Spawn.
Yes, I heard of that. which it's interesting. The first one, we actually rewatched it a couple nights ago, and it suffered a lot of pitfalls that the 90s did, that like the 90s had, like bad CGI and questionable acting beats in the movie. The saving point for me was John Leguizamo, or Ice Age Sid the Sloth, as he is known. Here's a character which he played, I can't remember his name, but the clown, the little clown in that movie, and he was just saving grace. He was funny, like unapologetically funny, inappropriate, and he was great. Everything else in the first Spawn from the 90s was just, it could be improved upon, because the movie did not age well. The CGI, it looks like bad Photoshop by today's standards. So I think Spawn, they could do it justice as long as they don't politicize it, because we all know how much politics makes everything better. Oh. Thank you. See? Here's my point.
Oh, but, I'd seen this Spawn movie, like, when I was like, really young.
Uh-huh.
So I barely remember it.
Oh, yeah?
Like, I remember bits and pieces of it.
No, it's, Spawn, the first one's actually on Netflix right now. You could, go ahead and experience it again. If you feel... if you feel like having a laugh at times. But I watched it for nostalgia's sake, and yeah, it was an enjoyable experience though.
That's cool, that's still enjoyable.
Yeah.
Another thing. So I haven't seen those Batman movies. Not the Tim Burton ones, but the ones after that.
Oh, you mean like Batman Returns and
yeah,
with like Arnold Schwarzenegger as DC's Mr.
Yeah,
Freeze.
Yeah. Yeah.
And Jim Carrey as DC's the Riddler.
Is that how they're credited?
No, that's just how I say it. Yeah.
How cool of you.
I know. But, yeah, those were definitely made for, I was a kid as when they came out. I can definitely say they were just pure fan service. Like, they were just made, they made everything like in a super cartoony and comic book way, and it shows and all the characters. Like, in those ones, Bane is just like a roided out freak, and he can only say like one syllable words, like, "Rrr, Bane, rrr."
Yeah.
Bane smash, you know. But then in like Christopher Nolan's, like, we see Bane as like what he truly is in the comics. Like, he's a master strategist. He's this correct, charismatic leader that can get his people to kill themselves for the cause. And yeah, so the first ones, they were just complete fan service. And but I still like them, you know. They're big.
Really?
They're bright and flashy, you know, because I was a kid. Like,
yeah, that's true. Yeah.
Bright colors, you know. Batman did that. He beat up a bad guy. Yeah. That type of thing.
So if you had extra time And those, like, one of those movies were on Netflix. Would you watch it?
Oh, yeah. I would. I would have to say I would. Just like, it's like it's one of those guilty pleasures for me.
Okay. Mix in with some nostalgia and boom.
Yeah, exactly. You got yourself a guilty pleasure. Let's see. Well, sadly, I think this is gonna have to be the last match for me.
No.
No, don't go. Damn, no. Dude.
Okay, it's okay.
Hmm? Oh. Well, I'm not listening to you. I'm not listening to you. That makes you feel bad.
So, okay, how about this? Horror movie.
Oh, okay. Horror movie favorite. I always ask this because some people are different, and also some people haven't seen this. Would Army of Darkness count as horror?
Be honest.
Yeah, be it.
I've seen Army of Darkness.
Oh, see, you're one of those only people that have never seen it. Okay, so I gotta suggest go look it up. I mean, it's an old 80s movie. You know, it's gonna be like an 80s movie.
Yeah.
But it's one of those that's like a cult classic because, just what it was based, like how the main character is, how. Oh! Oh God. Oh Jesus. Oh, I burned to death. He stepped in my potato mine. Suck it. So we're going for like classic or more main, not mainstream, but more current.
You can go back. That's well, not crazy enough. It's just that Army of Darkness, Evil Dead, those are like some of the last ones that I haven't seen.
Oh, okay. But I would definitely suggest watching Army of Darkness. Evil Dead was good, but still, I think Army of Darkness is way better. But as we're going for horror, I would have to say Jason has always been, you know, a favorite of mine that I could go to, because it's always him versus a bunch of dumb teenagers. They're like, oh no, what do we do? And he just rips them apart, and I love it. Yeah, what about you? What would you say is a favorite horror?
The Friday the 13th ones. Yeah, those are good. Those are
just classic.
Maybe the Halloween ones are good. I love Halloween.
Halloween, yeah.
Nightmare on Elm Street ones.
Yeah.
Those ones.
Like, I will say, like, watching Freddy Krueger as a kid, holy fuck, that'll give you nightmares, man. I mean,
yeah, I think, yeah, that was definitely one of my, probably like a top, because of, it got kind of creative at some point, you know? I guess because they kind of had to be like dreamlike. Some of it was kind of stupid, but some of it was really cool.
Yeah,
like some creative death going on there.
Yes, very much so.
But yeah, I think that would be my...
I'll say this too. I could not watch Chucky for the longest fucking time.
Really?
Yeah, because it legitimately scared me as a kid. Like, just a doll. Like, I get how, like, I see him now and I get the appeal of Chucky. Like, he's a smart ass fucking guy in a doll's body and kills people, you know, in funny ways. I get it. But as a kid, seeing, like, the first, like, that first one was just scary. I don't know why, man. It's just presented in a really creepy way.
Oh, that guy followed me and killed me.
Damn.
Oh, I gotta say, Texas Chainsaw Massacre.
Oh man.
The very first one.
Here we go, the very first one. You're talking about a scary movie, a classic movie, Nightmare Fuel. That was it right there. Just
gorgeous.
That one was just so gritty and gruesome and just like when he like cut that one, I think it was a dude, he cut the dude's leg off, hauled him away, salted his cut leg, and then just like speared him on like a rusty chain, like a hook and chain, like oh my god. Just nightmarish.
Yeah.
It was bold and ahead of its time.
Different. The first one, that was different. That was like new. It was interesting.
Yes. The first Saw was just like it brought up the subject again. How gruesome and just cringe-inducing can be a horror movie.
Oh hey.
Yeah, Saw was, oh man, just at the time, like, yeah, it took the cake, it took the winner.
Hold on, just a second. What year did that come out?
The first Saw.
Take a guess. I just looked it up. Take a guess.
Oh, first Saw. Wasn't it like 2006?
2004?
2004. Damn, dude.
I know. It didn't seem that long ago.
No. 13 years. Damn, dude. Yeah, not that long ago. Oh yeah, I exited out. Well, I'm
okay.
Back in this backyard now. So yeah, if you just tuned in, we were talking horrible comic book movies. The great comic book movies. Horrible horrors. And just classic horror movies. Some of our favorites. DRS Wagyoshi in the chat saying hello. What's up? What's up?
How's it going, Dr. Swag Yoshi?
There you go. showing some love for Dr. Swag Yoshi.
Yeah, it was a good time.
Yep, this was a good stream. I hope you all join us again. Follow us.
Hit that follow.
That follow, please. Show us some love on Twitter. Savage Time. You go ahead. Go ahead and plug the Savage Times. Let's hear that.
Boom! You did it. No, the Savage Times one on Twitter. That's the little handle, whatever. And the Savage Times TV. I think that's what it is on YouTube and Instagram.
Yeah, just yes, search up the Savage Times. You can't miss it. For sure. All right. Well, this has been fun. Thank you for joining us, Stripper Bandit.
Thank you for having me.
Flat. All right. We'll see y'all in the next time. Oh, right.